everybody. It's Marcy with Nona Snoop Shop. I'm going to be really quiet because it is about 11 o'clock at night on a Sunday. And everybody is in bed except for me. I've been up and working since I woke up this morning. It was a big closet clear out day for me. And I currently am running a sale of my closet too. So today's actually been the best sales day for me so far. Since I started on Poshmark just now 4 months ago. So anyway, I wanted to do a video today about how I pack all of my orders. And I'm actually doing this video for my buddy Lou Hustles, L-U-H-U-S-T-L-E-S, Lou Hustles. Because he's new to Poshmark and he is in need of some ideas and inspiration to pack up his packages. So I just wanted to go through the packages that I have ready to be shipped out tomorrow. And then just to give you all an idea. And then I was going to show you some of the supplies that I keep on hand and kind of where I get them and different ideas and different things to look out for. Okay, so Lou, this video is for you, buddy. You gave me the inspiration to do this video. Okay, so here we go. See, the first thing I did, now I pre-packaged everything. I haven't wrapped up the boxes, but everything is already pre-packaged. So I have a lady, she's actually my first repeat customer, so I'm excited about that. That I sold reading glasses to the other week, and then she reached back out to me because she liked them so much she wanted to know if I had any more. So I actually went shopping yesterday for her and got some listed today. And then I sent her a direct message through the bundle feature on Poshmark about the listings, and a pair that I had just listed, she bought them 15 minutes later. So I thought that was super awesome. So anyway, this is actually the pair that she did buy. And then I came across another pair that actually, both are new with tags, but the other pair actually had a flaw. And I don't want to take them back to the store, so I figured since she was my first repeat customer, I would send her the pair with the little flaw. It's just like a little tiny plastic nick in the lens. It's not even noticeable, but it's not something I want to sell, or if I did, I'd have to discount it and probably sit on it for a little while. So she's going to get both of these. So I have, of course, tissue paper. I do all of my, not all of them, but I do a lot of my thank you cards. These little thank you tags, and I try to color coordinate them with ribbon, of course. And then I have peanuts for the box to keep them safe, and I'm going to tuck them away in this. So that'll be her shipment. The next is a pair of white mountain shoes that I sold. And what I do with the shoes, so this is a little trick. Lou, you might already know this, I don't know. Is to take a pool noodle and you can cut it down. It helps keep the shoe, keep its shape. And then as you may know, I ran my closet with my kitty cat Wario, here he is, he's right here. So you might see him in the video. So I have a little paw print wrapping paper. So I just kind of wrapped it around there. Just to make it look a little bit nice. So, but these pole noodles are great. What I've done before, actually, I had suede boots that were real slouchy one time, and I wet them down a little bit, put the pool noodles in them, let them dry overnight, took the pool noodles out, and they just stood straight up. So those pool noodles are pretty awesome. And then when I store my shoes, I actually store them in the USPS shoe box. And then I just label on the outside what they are. So then what I'll do is when I ship this, I'll just put the shipping label over top of this. That way I can keep them stacked pretty well. Let's see, this was a bundle of a sweater and also eyeglasses. And guys, I'm telling you, these reading glasses that I have in my closet, they've been hot. They get a lot of likes and I've been been getting a lot of traction. I was kind of surprised because I actually just started by listing old reading glasses because I went to prescription. So something to look into if you guys can find reading glasses cheap. Great retail arbitrage, because you know you end up selling them quickly. I mean, it's great. So I have the sweater in here and the reading glasses in here, and again the color coordinated stuff. And I try to do goodie bags with candies, and then I have for the ladies, I have a butterfly nail file for them as well. And then I also came across some Tyvek wrapping that's new and clean, and some of the boxes I've just been lining with that, especially with the winter season coming up. Those are fun. Let's see that goes with that. This little bundle I thought was a lot of fun. I'll show you the inside of the box before I take it all out. So these are a little pair of little girl Converse that I came across. So I just wrapped those up, put tissue paper in, a goodie box, and I actually have some those fidget spinners. So I put a fidget spinner in there for the little girl along with the candies, and some stickers. And then for mom, I just wrote a personal note. And then I have some 3D floral stickers that I put on the back just to kind of dress it up a little bit. This is another pair of reading glasses that I sold. I found this really awesome, it's like a foil tissue paper. So I'll talk about that in a little while, but anyway, I just thought that was really cool the way that turned out. And then again, my cat, trying to brand myself. And then I have, for lining the box, I've got more of the wrapping paper with the paw prints. So for the guys, here's a No The Tags t-shirt that I sold. So this is what I do. I have some more masculine type tissue paper, and then I use twine and wrap it around again, the thank you note, and then lollipop. Here's another one with the kitty cat and the thank you note coordinated with that for the guys. A bundle of three pieces that I sold here. So I just stacked the three pieces, and I wrapped each one individually in the tissue paper, stacked them, and then added the thank you card, the ribbon, and again a little goodie bag. And I also came across these like corrugated cardboard. So actually what I can do is put one around each side, just to kind of help stabilize the package. And let's see, this is just a lady's top. Here, tissue paper, thank you card, ribbon, and then I have iron-on patches as well. So I just put a hole punch in that, and that's her thank you gift. A jewelry that I sold, so I just wrapped it up with a ribbon, and then I have butterfly nail file here. And I think that's it for my orders. So now let me take you over to my supplies. It's a little bit dark in here, so like I said, since everybody's kind of asleep, it's a little messy over here right now. So I apologize for that. It's been a little crazy today. But I'm excited because, like I said, it was my best sales day ever. So let me just turn